Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection, because perfection doesn't exist. I feel like it's been a while since I've done any kind of like K-beauty related thing, and Korean skincare is what really got me into like being really obsessed with skincare. And obviously like K-beauty is in every video of mine, but I want to do a dedicated K-beauty thing today. And I've recently become obsessed with Olive Young. They started shipping to the UK, I think it was only last year. And Olive Young for me is the place to go to if you want to know what is actually popular in Korea. Brands that are probably going to pop up here in a couple of years or so. And just some nice innovative formulations and ingredients and, you know, like the next big things. So I'm going to share some of my current favorite K-beauty products. Some of them are empty, some of them I'm midway through using. Products I enjoy using. Now, I actually paid for all these with my own money. However, Olive Young, I am an affiliate. So all links in the description box will be an affiliate link. I make a very small amount of money if you decide to click on them. If not, head over to Olive Young. Do what you need to do. But yes, these, I like these a lot. I'm going to start with like the brand that I'm obsessed with at the moment, and this is AESTURA. I'm not gonna show you this exact one because I've already talked about in a previous video. I'm gonna show you something else. But as I said, this brand is my CeraVe. They are a brand who concentrate on skin barrier restoration. I think they have like a few different categories within their brand, but the most popular products are their Atobarrier products. And these are products that help strengthen, repair. And you have all the ingredients you see in skin repairing products, fatty acids, cholesterol, Serums, of course. One of my current favorites. I fell in love with this cream, which I'm nearly out of. So then I ordered more, and this is the lotion. There's not a lot of difference between what's in here. What I do find though, that this gives me a matter finish than this does. So I prefer using the lotion in like a lighter weight formulation that leaves me more with a dewy glow. So these products actually contain an ingredient called hydroxypropyl dispalmitamide MEA, aka pseudoceramides. And this is an ingredient that has all the benefits of ceramides. To put it very, very plainly and simply, it's easier to formulate with. So helping with skin barrier function. And they're cheaper than real ceramides as well. And what I love about this brand, all in all, I've also got their, I got a sample, well, a mini of their Hydro Essence from the same line. I'm halfway through that. But what I love about all these products is that they're formulated so nicely. They take care of everything that usually thick, creamy, greasy, oily skin barrier repairing creams do, but without any of that. They are lightweight, they sink into the skin. They're oddly hydrating for barrier repairing products. I always feel like barrier repair always just concentrates on that top layer, right? That's what I always find. I always find like the product kind of sits on my skin. But with these, you can feel the hydration that's packed in here as well. And you can feel the goodness, not only repairing your skin barrier, but from deeper in the skin as well. I love these. I love this whole brand. I've got their cleanser, like a more gel creamy texture one, which I'm really looking forward to trying. But I just, once I'm done with them, I'll move on to the other like little subcategories they have in their brand. I absolutely love them. I believe they're like a bestseller in Korea. Like they are super, super popular, and I get why. I think they're amazing. Oh, this is one that I really didn't expect to like. This is the HANYUL Power Bean Serum. It's like pretty much done, actually. That's meant to be like an orangey yellow color. But bean seems to be like an overall theme in K-beauty at the moment. I don't know what kind of bean, but reading off the Olive Young website, I know nothing about, I'm going to be honest with you. But this is a serum for those who want firmer looking skin, firmer feeling skin, and want to regenerate their skin, whatever that might mean. Bean oil plus phytosterol gives a firming effect to the core of your skin, and peptide F penetrates into your skin to help give a firming effect. But this also contains ceramides as well to help restore that skin barrier. We have squalane in here. We have moisturizing betaine and denatured alcohol, which you can smell a fair bit. It doesn't have alcohol smell, but this isn't drying in any way. You have other ingredients in here helping to combat that. So I'm not overly sure about the scientific literature behind soybean oil is as far as like helping firm the skin, but I've been really enjoying this as a product that just makes my skin feel happy and healthy. And when I'm using this, I do see a difference in the kind of like just happiness and health of my skin. This is probably one of the serums I've used up like really quickly compared to other with serums, using it twice a day. I really like this. I can't speak much to the firmness of skin because I get Botox on my forehead, so I can't tell you how like firm it's made it. I get cheek filler as well, so not that that usually adds to firmness of skin, as in, you know, the collagen and elastin kind of side of it, but I don't know, as far as overall skin health and the glow of my skin and the barrier repair, I've been really, really enjoying this. Speaking of a bean, this is the Round Lab Soybean Nourishing Toner. This is actually targeted at those with dry skin and people with like irritated skin. So under ingredients, they have black bean extract, and they say that this brightens up the skin and freshens the complexion. I do get that. I get that a lot. It's incredibly soothing as well, actually, on my rosacea flare-ups. Again, we have ceramides in here to help with dehydrated skin, support barrier function, and sodium hyaluronate as one of the main ingredients that they talk about to help hydrate the skin. And what I would say about this toner is it's very simple, it's very nice, it's milky, it looks like a drink, but it does have this very nice soothing, calming effect to my skin. It's deeply, deeply hydrating. Like, you can feel your skin drinking this up. Again, one of its claims is helping to reduce fine lines and wrinkles. I can't speak to that. I don't have fine lines anywhere other than my forehead, and for that I get Botox. But as far as a nourishing, soothing, calming, hydrating toner goes, this is easily one of my favorites. I'm finding nowadays that a lot of brands are bringing out a lot of toners that give you kind of like a instant hydrating effect. And after a while, it's like, oh, my skin's kind of like tight again. Like it feels like, you know, but this seems to have like a lot of lasting power. I do prefer to layer this up though, because one kind of like in the palm of your hand and pat doesn't feel like enough. I need to use like one or two layers of this. But I really like it. I really, really like it. I started using this because I love the Round Lab sunscreen. I'm using a serum of theirs. Now that I've finished this one, I've moved on to the soybean serum, which I'm enjoying so far. I've literally been using it a week, so I can't say much about it yet. But I just love the hydration of this. On that note, this is the Lab Oligo Hyaluronic Acid 7 Multi-Formula Pads. These are made for people with sensitive skin because unlike kind of like those exfoliating peeling pads that are so popular under brands like Neogen, these don't have a lot of texture on them. And these pads are supposed to be left on the skin to hydrate your skin, using those lower molecular weights of hyaluronic acid alongside centella to really help soothe and calm as well. Again, another product that I love to just put on the roses of my cheeks to help soothe the redness and calm it down. If I've been out for a long walk with the dogs early morning, it's been freezing cold here as well. And you know when you come back from those walks and you're red and you feel dry where the wind has just been like ruining your face, these are nice just to quickly pat on and leave for 10-15 minutes and then just wipe away and pat in, and you can feel that hydration again. I prefer things like this to sheet masks, because with sheet masks I feel like I have this thing when I use sheet masks that I felt like I had to use them every day, whereas these feel, there's less of it, it feels less wasteful because I use these maybe like once or twice a week, if that. But they come with this little like these little tweezers as well to help pick them out. Really simple. I really, really like these. These are also packed with antioxidants as well as licorice root extract to help even and brighten out your skin tone. And yeah, allantoin as well to help soothe, a ton of soothing ingredients. But yeah, I really like these. I feel like they're a good all-rounder. I feel like they're great for people with even the most sensitive skin. These have kind of got me back into wanting to try pads again as more like point sheet masks rather than like an exfoliation step, because I felt like pads were just becoming like a physical exfoliant step. But no, I really like these. Next up is the HANYUL Yuja Sleeping Mask. Where's the front? There it is. I got this because I like the Sun By Me Yuja line in general, but I prefer HANYUL products and as a brand. So I thought their take on that kind of sleeping mask would be a lot better. And I was right, to be honest with you. The Sun By Me one feels very, very light. It sinks instantly into the skin. Whereas this sleeping mask has all those kind of like benefits of what you usually find, like a gel cream, brightening cream, the ingredients, the light texture on the skin, but with that more occlusive feel to it, where you wake up and you can still kind of feel that bit of moisturizer on your skin and your skin feels cared for rather than a little bit dry. We have the yuzu oil in here, which helps brighten the skin. It helps fade any hyperpigmentation. It's rich in antioxidants as well. We also have sunflower oil to like moisturize, as well as niacinamide being one of the key ingredients in here, again, to help even and brighten out your skin tone. Can potentially help tighten pores as well as help control sebum production. This is gonna be like an amazing summer overnight product. It smells really, really good, and there's like little capsules in here. You can't really see. And I presume that that's like the yuzu oil, kind of like little capsules. The thing about Olive Young is it doesn't give you a lot of information on the product. One of the antioxidants is actually carrot root extract, otherwise known as pro-vitamin A. You might have seen this in like the carrot oil sunbathing things that you shouldn't be using anymore, but you used to use when you used to go on holiday to help you tan quicker. It's like a tan accelerator, but it's also a really potent antioxidant with amazing skin regenerative properties, as well as fatty acids to help with your skin barrier as well. As well as ethyl ascorbyl ether, a great stable form of vitamin C. Again, antioxidant helps with brighter skin tone. This does have some fragrance in as well, and again, I don't mind that, to be honest with you. It doesn't bother me. It smells amazing. I really, really enjoy this. I've got so many Hanyul products now that I can't wait to try next because of this serum. Oh, there's a moisturizer version of this bean serum, which I will try as my next moisturizer after I finished the other two that I'm using at the moment. The last product is this eye balm by KAHI. I'm not sure. This is the eye balm. They do a few different balms, and these are basically stick balms. Nothing new that we haven't seen, but a kind of product that I feel is going to become more and more popular. So this is basically for people who want to just pay that little bit more attention under their eyes. I personally like to use this in the evening, so I'll do my moisturizer, a little bit of like eye cream, and then I'll put this balm all around my eyes. I've been getting very dry up here, so this kind of like it's like Vaseline-y feeling, but it's not really. This kind of like just feels like it's locking in any hydration that I add to my skin. This actually has fish collagen in, which Olive Young says helps replenish and moisturize the skin, making it firm and supple. And adenosine as well for fine lines and wrinkles around the eye area. It says that it can help with dark circles, but I don't think it helps. And at first I was like, oh my God, this is literally just like a petroleum stick. Like, I didn't think it was anything really, but when you look at the ingredients, it's actually a little bit more interesting than you initially think. So we have some antioxidants in here in the form of turmeric root. We have licorice extract in here as well. Again, another skin brightening ingredient. Sunflower seed oil, that's pretty much in everything, right? It's like, it's everywhere. But again, just moisturizing. It can help with skin barrier repair as well. They have apple seed oil, which I'm not sure. I don't know what that does, to be honest with you. I know that sometimes it's used as an exfoliant in some Korean exfoliators, but I don't know what the seed oil does, but it's in there. We also have sea buckthorn oil in here as well, moisturizing, fatty acids, all that kind of stuff. Really, I know I keep saying it, but it's like Vaseline in a stick with a lot more benefits. So whilst it does say eye balm, this is something that I've been using in any dry areas. When I laminate my eyebrows, you're meant to oil them, and I've actually just been running this over my eyebrows at night as well, because laminating your eyebrows make them dry. So just putting this oil over the tops kind of keeps them soft throughout the day. But essentially, I'm using this as Vaseline in a stick form. Dry areas, sometimes on the lips as well. Pop it in your bag, take it everywhere with you. And it's got hydrolyzed collagen in as well, which isn't really collagen, but it mimics kind of like moisturizing properties of collagen. So it's not just like a layer of thick, kind of like waxy feeling on your face. It's got some really nice moisturizing ingredients in as well. So there's an SPF stick as well, which I've got that I've not actually opened, which again I'm looking forward to using. But let me know your K-beauty favorites. Have a look on Olive Young and see if there's anything you like. I'm honestly addicted to it. I'm just scrolling on it all the time. I absolutely love it. I don't know why, because it's good. All the products in today's video in the description box down below, as I mentioned, they are all an affiliate link, so you can support me just by shopping through that way, or just by watching this video, to be honest with you. You don't have to shop through anything, but you've got some more product reviews here and some general light entertainment here. I'll see you over there.